Yeah, I've been since my early days. I've been stuck in my worldly ways. Propaganda, press, pan the camera. Please don't look at me in my face. Everybody might see my pain. Off the rail, might myself. But with life as aboard this plane. Steward this sex if I need help. Maybe with your last name. Hopefully it still ain't been changed. Something about you make me not doubt your awkward status. My brain scream louder. Asking when I'm gon' myself. Couple problems, my cash ain't help. Human issues too strong for tissue. False provider, war mask by wealth.
Move your body if you came here to party. If not, then pardon me. How I'm supposed to have a good time with death and destruction's all I see. I'll decide I'm out of my mind. The sound of sunshine is calling me. The vibrations is all I need. All I need, all I need.
Party people, yeah. Party people, I'd like to see you dance. Party people, yeah. Party people, I'd like to see you dance. Party people, move. Party people, I'd like to see you groove. This is how we do. This is how we do.
Deja vu from a bayside view. I see black cats in the daytime too. I see black cats on the daytime news. When handcuff wrist and his skin turn blue. I met God once at the rendezvous and fell starstruck.
Vince, the car's outside.
Got things to do, got to make my moves. I can't miss my flight and miss you too, boo. First class seat is overrated. Won't go unless they overpay us. Nowadays I'm overdating. My district for the hurt. Stay well acquainted. Their morning is calling me. Good vibrations is all I need. All I need, all I need.
Move your body if you came here to party. If not, then pardon me. How I'm supposed to have a good time with death and destruction's all I see. Out of sight, I'm out of my mind. The sound of sunshine is calling me. Good vibrations is all I need. All I need, all I need.
Party people, yeah. Party people, I'd like to see you dance. Party people, yeah. Party people, I'd like to see you dance. Party people, move. Party people, I'd like to see you groove. This is how we do. This is how we do.
Baby boo,
everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports.
From a city that's played host to 10 Super Bowls, here's a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans. Today, we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here between the San Francisco 49ers and the New Orleans Saints. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Now Palmer, eluding the pressure right. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. And the starting crew now for San Francisco.
I've been a big fan of Carlos Hyde since his days at Ohio State. A big, strong, physical runner, nimble feet, excellent vision downfield. And what I like about him when he's at his best, his ability to wear down a defense if he gets 20 or more carries in a game.
On second down, Palmer. Going down the middle, and it's complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. First carry for Carlos Hyde. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. And here now, New Orleans defensive unit.
Let's talk a little bit about safety Kenny Vaccaro. You can use him like the ultimate chess piece. Drop him in the box as a safety, turn him into a linebacker. Drop him back into coverage, he can play zone and also match up man-to-man against slot receivers, running backs, and tight ends.
Saints love that flexibility. He's been with them since coming into the league as a first-round pick in 2013. Now Palmer to throw on second down. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. And tapping those toes, he tried to get both in bounds. He could not do it, though.
In tap dance parlance, could not complete the shuffle. All right, needed to get that shuffle down with both feet, not just one.
Is that what they say?
There it is. You know, put a little sand down on the stage.
I'll take your word for it, my man. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. On second down, here's Palmer. Underneath for Johnson. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
The numbers on the ground for Hyde last week. 11 carries, 53 yards.
After the last game, they have plenty of reason to be confident in their running game. And even though they're facing a top 10 defense, they're not going to shy away from doing what they do best. Make them adjust to them. Make them stop what they do before they go to any type of a changeup.
It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on third down. From the shotgun, it's Palmer. Dancing to his left, under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
Tight, tight. They'll run for the first time with Mark Ingram. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. So the offense looking at a second and 8. Ingram again, and he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. They'll wind up losing 3, and now it's 3rd down. So add that tackle for a loss to the 2 that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. He's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run to the football, and the plays he's making, he spilled them in the offensive backfield.
And they get 14 yards there and a 1st down. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. It's a give to the right. Ingram trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because, you know, those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. You know darn well both of these teams reviewed the film and saw that this defense had 5 sacks last week. They got to keep their QB upright.
And they're going to try their best to do exactly that. But they're facing a team where getting to the quarterback is a mindset. It's a
under pressure again, and down he goes again. Navarro Bowman in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Niners will go on offense. 1st and 10. Throwing now. Palmer on 1st down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. Just a 1-yard pickup on the play, and it's a 2nd down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down. Palmer now, the throw on 3rd down. Well, they would have gotten a conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be 4th down.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? 3rd and short, they elect to throw for it. And that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on 3rd and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the 1st quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. Ooh, with a juke. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. And that's a 48-yard punt with the coverage holding him to 3 on the return. And the Saints will take over with a 1st down and 10. The drive starts here with a carry by Ingram. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. A look there at Ingram's numbers from a week ago. 13 carries, 53 yards.
Well, watching the film, we saw that things clicked pretty well for them in the running game last week. No reason to change in my mind. Continue to try and run the football, give it to him early and often in hopes of breaking down the defense. So some
a breakaway from Michael Thomas. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, his 2nd touchdown on the season, and the Saints have taken the early lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. The Niners on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. From the gun, it's Palmer. Flush to his right. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. They convert on third with a gain of 22. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary. Figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. Second and 10. It's Palmer again. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. The numbers for him from a week ago. 7 catches, 125 yards.
Having a nice season. Number 8 in the league in receiving yards. And not just making his team happy, but anyone who's picked him in fantasy football.
A first down carry here for Johnson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. On first down, it's Palmer. Buying time to his left. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. No one there to help out downfield, but no problem. Scrambling for 22 and a first.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him. And he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. It'll be a gain of 5 there as they move closer. It's 2nd and goal. They're mounting a nice drive here. Good chunk of yardage there again. O-line, they've been solid this drive.
They have that look about them right now.
And across the goal line, into the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Niners are able to cash in for 6. And that moment we just saw, always so special for any rookie, the first touchdown of his career.
And there's nothing like anticipation, is there? You know he's been dreaming about it, thinking about it. It's been a part of every bit of his being. And finally, it gets done. He's got to feel great right now.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Encroachment defense.
So step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know, defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that one.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Encroachment defense.
Well, they didn't really have to earn that first down, did they?
Well, they're not having to earn much, are they? Back-to-back penalties. First was 1st and 5, and now they give them a first down.
First down, he'll drop to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's doing.
Well, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Solomon Thomas in there to get him, and that's sack number six for him on the year.
So, Brandon, we've sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. They'll look to throw here. And he finds his man, Kamar Aiken. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll make this a second down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Kamara. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
On second down, Kamara. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. And I think he's a guy, if they had let him walk, no one was going to be shouting from the top of a mountain, but he's a good guy. He's a good locker room guy, too.
Good locker room and a good player. I mean, he's a valuable starter for them. And if you just want to start over and maybe bring in someone new, the learning curve might be a little bit big, so it's a good job by getting him taken care of, and now they can move forward.
8 yards there on a first down.
There are a lot of tough routes to try and cover. When you see a runner come out of the backfield and run this angle route, looks like they're going to the flat, and then they put their foot in the ground and cut back sharply inside. Not easily covered, and then when they catch it, good momentum built up by them as well.
And able to pick up the first.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss.
False start, offense.
Not easy being a rookie left tackle in this league, and there they got him for the penalty.
Not easy at all. Think about what you're dealing with every game you play. Ostensibly, the best pass rusher is over you on every snap. I'd be a little jumpy myself.
Catch left side here by Aiken, and he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards, and that's going to make it fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. To throw on second down, Palmer. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
Now, coach is always harped on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Now a play fake here on first down. Flushed out right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down. Now Palmer to throw. Being chased out left. And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
They'll try and throw for it with Palmer. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Saints will have the football back. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen... both been to practices where we've seen, hey, third down situation, big third down alert, lock in here, fourth down play, make sure you focus just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
Green 39, green 39.
Again, they'll run with Ingram. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the pickup, and they're going to face a third down.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And drop to throw, looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does. Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. He'll drop to throw. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Willie Snead, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints have moved out in front. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17 to 10. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. A minute 57 to go in this first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. Now Palmer on first down. He finds an opening past the 40. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pick up there of 20 yards. They go play action here on first down. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Holding offense.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Out of the gun, Palmer. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there, second down.
I know we're just in the second quarter and there's a ways to go in this game, but that's his second drop. I'm wondering if that's a little bit of an alarm bell for them when they start calling plays on the offensive side of the ball.
His eyes already looking upfield on that last one before he brought it in. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. It'll be a gain of 11, and just like that, it's third down. Palmer now. Escaping the pressure right. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Now Palmer. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
There they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, but they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back. But that's one.
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked off at the 33. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Third down, passing down. Throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have five defensive backs on the field and an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
Fielded about a yard deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Now it's Palmer, and that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. He's got his man on the crossing route. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. And the 13-year man puts it through, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. So they're still down, but they are able to salvage 3 here heading into the lockers.
This is what you work on from the beginning of training camp. Heading into the half, put some points on the board. No matter what the score says at that point, you've accomplished what you set out to do.
So it's halftime here in New Orleans with a six. And no update from Larry this week, apparently. We'll try again in week 7. But for now, let's get back to the action, ready to kick off the second half. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he spins through. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. A nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Back to throw now on second and 10. And Aiken with it over the middle. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Out of the gun now on third down. It's complete to Flaner. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield across the 45. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first.
They brought in the heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Navarro Bowman, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Left side and caught by Flaner. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And that is incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter 3.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. On second down, here's Palmer. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you can see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. To throw is Palmer. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Down right around the 25. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
We'll give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Looked like defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
This will be caught just inside the 10. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. A great effort there. With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the 49ers are back within a score. Nice execution there. Good job by the O-line getting him in for the second time.
And you always have to start with credit there when you're having a big game. I mean, you don't get there by yourself. That's rare. But how about the ability to see the proper holes, pick the proper place to go, and find his way into the end zone.
Gold now out to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got that to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
They run. It's Mark Ingram. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
I haven't met a football team yet that runs the ball successfully that doesn't talk about having an attitude to be a running football team, right? You've got to be able to put your nose in there, smell where the first down sticks on, and get there.
They give them 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. This is Ingram on first and 10. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And it'll be second and 12. Hurry up, here we go, Mike. A handoff. It's Mark Ingram. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of 1, and it'll be a third and about 13.
It's really easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given a little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff. Partner, the way this offense has marched up and down the field during this game, it's almost a surprise to see an incomplete pass on third down, isn't it?
Yeah, they have had their foot on the gas all game long, but here finally stalling out. Yeah, here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. Now this is fielded in the end zone. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the Niners will take over at the 20. They begin the drive with Johnson. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and 1.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
On second down, Johnson. Room here. There goes Duke Johnson. He's at the 40. Past the 20. 10. Touchdown, 49ers. Duke Johnson. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers have now taken the lead. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up.
And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. And in the third quarter here, they were trying to push that to a 3-point game, but instead it'll stay at one.
And I'm a big proponent of not chasing points or going for two too early. But in this case, I understand why. You know, if you kick an extra point, you're just up two,
yeah,
right? So a field goal still puts the other team ahead. So you go for two here and protect the field goal lead. They didn't get it done, though.
Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. And right now, probably just one thing in his mind. It's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens, the quarterback, as you know, is usually the leader of the squad. Now there's probably a silent camaraderie that comes.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Eli Harold in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
On second down, Ingram. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout as there's a Saints player down here on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. The Saints on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This will be third and a mile. Back to throw. This is going to be incomplete. Here's Thomas Morstead now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Fielded at about the 28. Nifty footwork at the 45. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Play action. It's Palmer. Steps away. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that'll make it third and 13.
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like...
And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Haole Kikaha. In there to drop him for a 4-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
They have, by the way, gone to the third quarter now at Ford Field in Detroit. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Todd Gurley, with his last carry, just hit 100 yards on the ground.
Let's go! Blue landed!
They start the drive on the ground. Kamara, and heavy contact. He is knocked down hard. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
And I can see why they're ranked fourth in the NFL against the run. I mean, they are tough to move the ball against. I mean, they have a little bit of everything, right? Run stoppers inside, guys who can make plays outside.
We've seen them shut down running games already this year. They're at it again. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth, you know, because you always hear about the smaller running back. Oh, he gets lost, you can't find him, and sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guys.
Back now here live in New Orleans. And we've got a dandy here. A 1-point game as we begin the fourth.
Let's go! Shepard!
They'll look to throw here on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. On the check down, he finds Kamara. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
To throw. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Saints have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is the absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
He'll get three up to midfield.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
From midfield now, here's Palmer. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains. They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. Over the middle, it's complete. Oh, no, he lost the football. The Saints say they have it, and they do. And this is one of those bang-bang plays, Charles. Did the knee hit first or did the...
After reviewing the play, the run on the field is reversed.
On the toss, here's Johnson. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. On second down, Palmer. And that'll be incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much. And your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Eluding the pressure right. And incomplete. Almost intercepted. The D lineman almost had it. Couldn't hang on. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get...
picked off.
That could possibly seal this one. Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
All right, here we go. Watch it now, Barney. Barney. Ah!
They begin on the ground with Kamara. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves them with 3rd and 5. And in this situation with the lead, 4th quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line. That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a 4th down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, 1st down. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. He'll return it from the 6. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards, well struck. And the 49ers will take over deep in their own territory. And not great starting field position here for the offense. Throwing now, Palmer on 1st down. Underneath for Johnson. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. Call it a gain of 5. And that'll make it a 2nd down. From the gun, it's Palmer. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down just shy of the 40. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. On 1st down, it's Palmer. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Complete.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch, but underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get, because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is taken at the 18, and he is out of bounds, getting it just shy of the 35. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And that will come the offense as they take over.
Let's go! Boom, land it!
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's got it over the middle, Flaner. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
I got the sense that the defense created a little momentum for them there, didn't they?
Did their job, forced the punt. Now, nice start to the drive. Offense has to do their part.
Yeah, they certainly do, but what a great start for them. They got to thank the guys on D.
They'll look to throw, and the tight end has it, Fleener. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Kobe Fleener. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Saints add on to their lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call. But he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. On first and 10, it's Palmer. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Now a play fake here on first down. Steps away to his left. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So he can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard. Maybe from you. I don't know. But you're going to get hit anyways. Might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player. No chance at all. Way easier said than done.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Now Palmer. And this one is incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Second and 10, it's Palmer again. Flush to his right. And he comes back with one complete. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20 at the 15. 15 yards down to the 15 and a first down. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. Now Palmer to throw on second down. This is caught. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Garrett Salick. His first touchdown on the year. And the 49ers have cut it back within a score. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Gold now out to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
It's a gain of 13 for number 13, and it gives him a first down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Let's go! Green 39! Green 39!
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off.
Here we go now. All right now. Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he'll take this forward for two, maybe three. But we do have a flag down, and they're already marching backward.
Holding offense.
That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
Following the penalty, it's Kamara. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. Again, it's Kamara. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. And the 49ers going to take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back.
Let's go, look at 56.
On third down. Here's Kamara. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. And a timeout here. Timeout taken. Whistles blown. Timeout taken by the receiving team. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. Taken in at the 11. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Getting set to go again, here's Carson Palmer heading back onto the field. This is something we've seen many times over the course of his career. Can he pull off a... And he can't get a throw off! He's taken down! What a huge play at this point in the game! Palmer, cool under pressure as he rallies his guys to the line of scrimmage. They'll look to throw. Screen play, Johnson. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. Give them 5 on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Manti Te'o. The Saints in victory formation now as they'll take the knee. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it.
Offside. Defense.
And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Points in this one, you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put.